Okay. Well, good evening, everybody, and welcome to this week's Classic Country A to Z show. Tonight, we'll start by covering a few of Lynn Anderson's songs, and then we'll move into some Mac Davis hits, both songs that he recorded and wrote, and some that he wrote for others, a couple that he wrote for others that were big hits. Anyway, as a point of reference to show how differently singing careers can be made, Lynn Anderson did not write or co-write any of her hits, and Mac Davis wrote all of his. So, and both had great careers, although it's possible Mac Davis might have made more money just because of the fact that he was a songwriter. So anyway, but Lynn Anderson had more big hits, so who knows? As always, of course, there'll be an original hit, let's be optimistic, original song in the middle, and then a gospel song at the end, as usual. So, although Lynn Anderson was actually born in Grand Forks, North Dakota, she was raised in California by her mother, Liz Anderson, who was also a country singer and songwriter. Lynn Anderson's musical career, recording career, began in 1966. She was spotted by a record producer while singing a duet with her mother, and her career ended when she passed away in 2015. Along the way, she had 5 number one hits and 18 top 10 hits. And our first song tonight was Lynn's first top 10 hit. When this song hit as number 5 in 1967. Lynn first performed the song on the Lawrence Welk Show, on which she was a regular as the sort of designated country and western singer on the Lawrence Welk Show for at least a couple years. This song was written by Lynn's mother, Liz, and it's called If I Kiss You, Will You Go Away? If I kiss you, will you go away? Like in the game my mother used to play. You're so much hurt, I wish you wouldn't stay. If I kiss you, will you go away? Well, my mom would come when I'd get hurt at play. She'd kiss my hurt and it would go away. But now I'm grown and I don't know what to do, 'cause I've never known a bigger hurt than you. So if I kiss you, will you go away? Like in the game my mother used to play. You're so much hurt, I wish you wouldn't stay. If I kiss you, will you go away? I've seen her kiss make sorrow disappear. A kiss can drive away the biggest tears. A kiss can make a heartache vanish too. I don't see why it wouldn't work on you. So if I kiss you, will you go away? Like in the game my mother used to play. You're so much hurt, I wish you wouldn't stay. If I kiss you, will you go away? If I kiss you, will you go away? Okay, now next up, later that same year, Lynn released this next song that rose all the way to number 4 for her, making it her biggest career hit at that time. This song is called Promises, Promises. Mm.
You promised you would be true to me, but we both know you could never be. You've been putting me on since the day we met. Promises, promises, that's all I ever get. That's all I ever get. Then you promised me a ring, a wedding gown and all of them things. But I ain't seen no diamond yet. Promises, promises, that's all I ever get. That's all I ever get. Promises, promises, that's all I get. All you gave me since the day we met. You make my heart into again, I bet. Promises, promises, that's all I ever get. That's all I ever get. And now you tell me you're going away. You swear to me this time you'll stay. But I can't believe I'm not rid of you yet. Promises, promises, that's all I ever get. That's all I ever get. Promises, promises, that's all I get. All you gave me since the day we met. You'll break my heart in two again, I bet. Promises, promises, that's all I ever get. That's all I ever get. Promises, promises, that's all I get. Promises, promises, that's all I get. Promises, 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 that's all I get.
I debated all week long on how to end that song, and here we get to the final shot and still didn't figure it out. Okay, in the actual recording, she just kind of fades away, and it just repeats and repeats, and it just fades away, but I can't really do that here, so. Okay, next up. This song was written by Lynn's production collaborator and husband at the time, Glenn Sutton, and became a number 7 hit for her in 1970. This song is called Stay There Till I Get There. Gail, you should like a lot of these. There's a lot of up-tempo songs in Lynn Anderson's collection.
The telephones are ringing, it's 3 a.m. and I know just who's calling. From the same old spot, you're about half shot and almost a point of crawling. Why is it every time we have a little fuss, you take your wounded pride and you head right straight for a bar and a bottle and you try to crawl inside? Please stay there till I get there. We'll work it out together. We'll take a little walk and have a little talk and you'll feel a whole lot better. Just when I wonder if you're really worth the trouble that you put me through, then you roll them baby blue eyes at me and I jump like a kangaroo. Please stay there till I get there. We'll work it out together. We'll take a little walk and have a little talk and you'll feel a whole lot better. I thought about leaving you many times and I've even packed my bags a few, but the telephone rings and I can't do a thing but run straight to you. So please stay there till I get there. We'll work it out together. We'll take a little walk and have a little talk and you feel a whole lot better. Please stay there till I get there. We'll work it out together. We'll have a little walk and have a little talk and you feel a whole lot better. And you feel a whole lot better.
Okay, let's see. Next up, this was sort of Lynn's, this was her signature song and her first number one hit. The song was written by singer-songwriter Joe South in 1967 and Lynn recorded it in 1970. After hearing Joe South's recording. However, Lynn's producer originally rejected the song's recording because he didn't consider it to be a female tune. But after much convincing, Lynn recorded it and released the song that became a crossover hit after it reached both the country and pop charts. The song also became a major hit worldwide, reaching the number one spot in multiple countries. Arguably her biggest hit, this is Rose Garden.
I beg your pardon, I never promised you a rose garden. Along with the sunshine, there's gotta be a little rain sometimes. But when you take, you gotta give. So live and let live, or let go. Oh, 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 I beg your pardon, I never promised you a rose garden. I could promise you things like big diamond rings, but you don't find roses growing on stalks of clover. So you better think it over. Well, if sweet talking you could make it come true, I would give you the world right now on a silver platter. But what would it matter? So smile for a while and let's be jolly. Love shouldn't be so melancholy. Come along and share the good times while we can. I beg your pardon, I never promised you a rose garden. Along with the sunshine, there's gotta be a little rain sometime. Yeah, when you take, you gotta give. So live or let live, or let go. Oh, 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 I beg your pardon, I never promised you a rose garden. Well, I could sing you a tune and promise you the moon, but if that's what it takes to hold you, I'd just as soon let you go. But there's one thing I want you to know. You better look before you leap. Still waters run deep, and there won't always be someone there to pull you out. And you know what I'm talking about. So smile for a while and let's be jolly. Love shouldn't be so melancholy. Come along and share the good times while we can. I beg your pardon, I never promised you a rose garden. Along with the sunshine, there's gotta be a little rain sometimes. I beg your pardon, I never promised you a rose garden. Along with the sunshine, there's gotta be a little rain sometimes. I beg your pardon, I never promised you a rose garden.
All right, now this is another Joe South pen song that Lynn released, this one in 1971. It also reached number one on the charts for her. And this one is called How Can I Unlove You?
Well, how can I unsay the things I said to you? How can I undo the things that we used to do? Tell me, how can I unfeel the way I feel for you? How can I unlove you? Well, how can I untie the hold that you've got on me? When you won't unchain my heart and set me free? Well, I can't unremember every memory. So how can I unlove you? I'll never, never uncry the tears that I cried when you said goodbye. No, I'll never, never unmiss the thrill that I miss when we used to kiss. Well, how can I unsay the things I said to you? And how can I undo the things that we used to do? Tell me, how can I unfeel the way I feel for you? Can I unlove you? No, I'll never, never uncry the tears that I cried when you said goodbye. No, I'll never, never unmiss the thrill that I missed when we used to kiss. So how can I unsay the things I said to you? How can I undo the things that we used to do? Tell me, how can I unfeel the way I feel for you? How can I unlove you? Oh, how can I unlove you? Oh, how can I?
Okay, now in the early to mid-70s, there was a rock-pop duo called Loggins and Messina with Kenny Loggins and Dan Messina. And Dan Messina wrote this next song, and Loggins and Messina released it in 1971. And then Lynn used this as the title track to her 1972 album and had a number four hit with the song. As a side note, the video that Lynn recorded for this song is about as dorky as they come, really, in old country music videos. And I'll just leave it at that. You can look it up and watch it if you want. But this is called Listen to a Country Song.
It's Saturday night and my daddy's up late picking with my Uncle Bill. The neighbors don't mind cause they have a good time sipping on my pappy still. Old brother Ben got a fiddle in his hands and mama's on the mandolin. When the music is right and the band is tight, you wanna see him pick and grin. Well, everybody starts moving to the sound of the guitar strums, and everybody starts grooving to the beat of the rhythm and drums. So come along and get yourself really on and rock to the music and fun. Sip that wine and have a really good time and listen to a country song. Sheriff Brown never comes around knocking on that old back door. Well, as a matter of fact, you can find him out back picking on his old banjo. My brother Jack sneaks out from the back trying to get to Sister Sue. She She throws them on the ground without turning around, 'cause she knows a little jujitsu. And everybody starts moving to the sound of the guitar strums. Everybody starts grooving to the beat of the rhythm and drums. So come along and get yourself a really on and rock to the music and fun. Sip that wine and have a really good time and listen to a country song. Just sip that wine and have a really good time and listen to a country song.
All right. Now, speaking of title track songs, this next song was co-written by Lynn's husband, Glenn Sutton, another one of those, and was released as the title track for her 1973 album. The song rose all the way to number one on the charts for her, and the song and the album are called Keep Me in Mind. Craig, glad to have you with us. We watched the Vikings Browns game today, disappointing, and I left the Packers game at halftime, so don't know how that's ending up. But anyway, keep me in mind.
Seems to go wrong. Your heart wants to sing, but it can't find a song. When it seems that the world has left you behind, keep me in mind. When you think that life is just passing you by, you look but you can't find a reason to try. When it seems that a friend is so hard to find, keep me in mind. Keep me in mind, 'cause I'll never stop loving you. And as long as I live, I'll have love to give, and I'll give it all to you, just you. When the dreams that you've chased have all gotten away, and you stand at the end of a long, lonely day, you will never be far from these arms of mine. Keep me in mind. When the dreams that you've chased have all gotten away, and you stand at the end of a long, lonely day, you will never be far from these arms of mine. Keep me in mind. Keep me in mind.
All right, now for our last Lynn Anderson song, this is another title track song for her. This one from early 1973. This one was co-written by Richard Carpenter from the pop duo The Carpenters. And the Carpenters first recorded this song in 1972, and they originally intended the song to just be a sort of a deep cut in their 1973 album and not release it as a single. But after Lynn Anderson covered the song in early 1973 and had a number two hit with it on the country charts, the Carpenters sat down and re-recorded their original version, and they released it as a single, and it became a number one pop hit for them in 1973. So this song got around to a lot of radios. This song and the album, Lynn's album, are called Top of the World.
Such a feeling's coming over me. There is wonder in most everything I see. Not a cloud in the sky, got the sun in my eyes, and I won't be surprised if it's a dream. Well, everything I want the world to be is now coming true, especially for me. And the reason is clear, it's because you are here. You're the nearest thing to heaven that I see. I'm on the top of the world, looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world. Something in the wind has learned my name, and it's telling me that things are not the same. In the leaves on the trees and the touch of the breeze, there's a pleasing sense of happiness for me. Well, there is only one wish on my mind. When this day is through, I hope that I will find that tomorrow will be just the same for you and me. All I need will be mine if you are here. Well, I'm on the top of the world, looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world. I'm on the top of the world, looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world. I'm on the top of the world, looking down on creation, and the only explanation I can find is the love that I've found ever since you've been around. Your love's put me at the top of the world.
Okay, now we move on to Mac Davis and his collection of hits. Mac was born and raised in Lubbock, Texas. And he began his musical career as a songwriter only, and he wrote several songs for Elvis Presley, Bobby Goldsboro, Nancy Sinatra, B.J. Thomas, and many others. Mac was also an actor, appearing in 11 movies, big screen movies, 8 TV movies, and 1 short film. And he passed away just 1 year ago at the age of 78 from complications following heart surgery. Mac Davis started recording back in 1962, but his first charting success is our first song tonight, this one from 1970, when this song reached number 25 on the adult contemporary charts. In a 2017 interview, Max said the song was inspired when he was in England at a party at Maurice Gibb's home from the Bee Gees. And Max said, quote, I went to the kitchen and fixed myself a drink at the party, and there were a bunch of hippie types, and they were going to have a seance. And they asked me if I'd like to join them, and I said, no, man, I don't think so. Really wasn't my thing. And then someone asked, don't you believe in the occult? And he said, no, I believe in music. And the second I said it, I just went, I believe in music. I looked around. It was like a God shot. I saw one of Maurice Gibb's guitars sitting on a stand, and I picked it up and started strumming it. And I had the hook before I left the party. Years later, I Believe in Music became my signature song, and I closed every show with it. You can definitely hear the hippie themes from the early 70s in the lyrics of this song, which is called I Believe in Music. I could just sit around making music all day long. As long as I'm making my music, ain't gonna do nobody no harm. And who knows, maybe someday I'll come up with a song to make people wanna stop this fussing and fighting long enough to sing along. And I believe in music. Oh, I believe in love, and I believe in music. Oh, I believe in love. Well, music is love, and love is music, if you know what I mean. People who believe in music are the happiest people I've ever seen. So clap your hands and stomp your feet and shake those tambourines. Lift your voices to the sky, God loves you when you sing. And I believe in music. Oh, I believe in music. Oh, I believe in love. Well, music is the universal language, and love is the key to peace and hope and understanding and living in harmony. So take your brother by the hand and come along with me. Find out what it really means to be rich and young and free. 'Cause I believe in music. Oh, I believe in love. And I believe in music. Oh, I believe in love. Yes, I believe in music. Oh, I believe in love. All right, now we've reached the portion of the show where I do one of our original songs that my friend Charlie and I wrote together. This song is about realizing your relationship is over and not wanting to know the details behind why. This song is called Tell Me How. Thank you.
Don't tell me who, don't tell me where, don't tell me why or when. Just tell me how can I ever trust you again? Well, when your phone rings tonight, you hurry from the room. Soon you're heading for the door wearing your best perfume. It's a work thing, you say, I'll be back in a while. Well, please don't wait up, you say, but you can't hide your smile. Don't tell me who, don't tell me where, don't tell me why or when. Just tell me how can I ever trust you again? Well, when you crawl into bed, I pretend I'm asleep. It's well after midnight, oh, the secrets you keep. You think you're so smart and that I'll never know. But I know it's time for me to go. Don't tell me who, don't tell me where, don't tell me why or when. Just tell me how can I ever love you again? Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. Only a fool would stay with you. But that fool won't be me. So don't tell me who, don't tell me where, don't tell me why or when. Just tell me how can I ever love you again? Just tell me why would I ever love you again?
Okay, back to Mac Davis. This next one, this song only went to number 26 on the country charts for Mac, but it was a number one hit on both the pop and adult contemporary charts, 1972, and was his only song to reach number one on any chart. He wrote this song when the record company demanded he write a tune with a hook. This song was the title track for his album that year, and the song and the album are called Baby Don't Get Hooked on Me.
Girl, you're getting that look in your eyes, and it's starting to worry me. And I ain't ready for no family ties. Nobody's gonna hurry me. Just keep it friendly, girl, 'cause I don't wanna leave. Don't start clinging to me, girl, 'cause I can't breathe. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. 'Cause I'll just use you, then I'll set you free. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. Girl, you're a hot-blooded woman, child, and it's warm where you're touching me. I can tell by your trembling smile, you're seeing way too much in me. Girl, don't let let your life get tangled up with mine. 'Cause I'll just leave you, I can't take no clinging vine. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. 'Cause I'll just use you, then I'll set you free. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me. 'Cause I'll just use you, then I'll set you free. Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me.
So you see the catch there. When the studio told him they wanted him to write a song with a hook in it, he wrote the whole song around that. Anyway, a hook is just, you know, like a part of a traditional song that catches you. We're going into too much detail. All right, Mac had a little help in writing our next song. Doc Severinsen from The Tonight Show gave Mac the title to this song after Mac had appeared on The Tonight Show with Johnny Carson. In fact, Mac Davis actually guest hosted sometimes for Johnny Carson as well, but he was a frequent performer there. Anyway, Doc Severinsen gave him the idea for the title for this song. It didn't really do much at all for Mac in the country charts, you know, peaking only at number 40, but it went to number 9 on the pop charts and number 1 on the adult contemporary charts. This song was also the title track to his album that year, and the song and the album are called Stop and Smell the Roses.
Hey, mister, where you going in such a hurry? Don't you think it's time you realized there's a whole lot more to life than work and worry? And the sweetest things in life are free, and they're right before your eyes. Well, you gotta stop and smell the roses. You gotta count your many blessings every day. You're gonna find your way to heaven is a rough and rocky road if you don't stop and smell the roses along the way. Before you went to work this morning in the city, did you spend some time with your family? Did you kiss your wife and tell her that she's pretty? Did you take your children to your breast and love them tenderly? Well, you gotta stop and smell the roses. You gotta count your many blessings every day. You're gonna find the way to heaven is a rough and rocky road if you don't stop and smell the roses along the way. Did you ever take a walk through the forest? Stop and dream a while among the trees. Well, you can look up through the leaves right straight to heaven, and you can almost hear the voice of God in each and every breeze. So you gotta stop and smell the roses. You gotta count your many blessings every day. You're gonna find the way to heaven is a rough and rocky road if you don't stop and smell the roses along the way. Yeah, you gotta stop and smell the roses. You gotta count your many blessings every day. You're gonna find the way to heaven is a rough and rocky road if you don't stop and smell the roses along the way.
Okay. Diane, thanks for joining. All right, so after that last hit in 1974, Mac Davis had several slower years until 1980 with this next album title track. Somewhat of a tongue-in-cheek song. This one brought him back into the top 10 on the charts. The universal appeal of this song drove many artists to cover the song all around the world. And it was a number one hit in many markets around the world. Willie Nelson also just covered this song 2 years ago in 2019. And this song, I'm assuming it wasn't autobiographical, but this song is called It's Hard to Be Humble.
It's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. I can't wait to look in the mirror, 'cause I get better looking each day. To know me is to love me. I must be a hell of a man. Oh Lord, it's hard to be humble, but I'm doing the best that I can. Well, I used to have a girlfriend, but I guess she just couldn't compete with all of these love-starved women who keep clamoring at my feet. Well, I probably could find me another, but I guess they're all in awe of me. Who cares? I'll never get lonesome, 'cause I treasure my own company. Oh, Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. I can't wait to look in the mirror, 'cause I get better looking each day. To know me is to love me. I must be a hell of a man. Oh Lord, it's hard to be humble, but I'm doing the best that I can. Well, I guess you could say I am a loner, a cowboy outlaw, tough and proud. Oh, I could have lots of friends if I wanted, but then I wouldn't stand out from the crowd. Some folks say that I'm egotistical. Hell, I don't even know what that means, but I guess it has something to do with the way that I fill out my skin-tight blue jeans. Oh, Lord, it's hard to be humble when you're perfect in every way. I can't wait to look in the mirror, 'cause I get better looking each day. To know me is to love me. I must be a hell of a man. Oh, Lord, it's hard to be humble, but I'm doing the best that I can. Yeah, I'm doing the best that I can.
All right. Yep. Gail and Craig, that's a super fun song. It's in some ways a little awkward to sing it, but it's a fun song for sure. All right, next up, another album title track song that Mac wrote and recorded in 1980, and it became a number 9 hit for him that year. This song is somewhat autobiographical, as he was born and raised in Lubbock, Texas, which was also Buddy Holly's hometown. Mac is quoted as saying this is his favorite song. And apparently, at his death, he was, in fact, buried in his blue jeans in Lubbock. And the song and the album are called Texas in My Rearview Mirror. I was just 15 and out of control, lost to James Dean and rock and roll. I knew down deep in my country soul that I had to get away. Well, Hollywood was a lady in red that danced in my dreams as I tossed in bed. I knew I'd wind up in jail or dead if I had to stay. Yeah, I thought happiness was Lubbock, Texas in my rearview mirror. My mama kept calling me home, but I just did not want to hear her. And the vision was getting clearer in my dreams. So I lit out one night in June, stoned on the glow of a Texas moon, humming an old Buddy Holly tune called a Peggy Sue. With my favorite jeans and a cheap guitar, I ran off chasing a distant star. If Buddy Holly could make it that far, I figured I could too. 'Cause I thought happiness was Lubbock, Texas in my rearview mirror. Well, my mama kept calling me home, but I just did not want to hear her. And the vision was getting clearer in my dreams. But the Hollywood moon didn't smile the same old smile that I'd grown up with. And the lady in red just wanted my last dime. And I cried myself to sleep at night, too dumb to run, too scared to fight, and too proud to admit it at the time. So I got me some gigs on Saturday nights, not much more than orchestrated fights. I'd come home drunk and I'd try to write, but the words came out wrong. Hell-bent and bound for a wasted youth, too much gin and not enough vermouth, and no one to teach me how to seek the truth before I put it in the song. Now I thought happiness was Lubbock, Texas in my rearview mirror. My mama kept calling me home, but I just did not want to hear her. And the vision was getting clearer in my dreams. Now I thank God each and every day for giving me the music and the words to say. I'd have never made it any other way. He was my only friend. And now I sleep a little better at night, and when I look in the mirror in the morning light, man I see was both wrong and right. He's going home again. I guess happiness was Lubbock, Texas in my rearview mirror. But now happiness is Lubbock, Texas, growing nearer and dearer. And the vision is getting clearer in my dreams. And I think I finally know just what it means. When I die, you can bury me in Lubbock, Texas, in my jeans. Now, this next song, of Max was on that same Texas in My Rearview Mirror album. And this also slightly autobiographical tune, reached number two on the charts in 1981 for him. This song is called Hooked on Music.
New Year's Eve, I was 14 at the time. I was celebrating 4 a.m. with them hoodlum friends of mine. I heard a boy named Elvis Presley singing, "That's All Right, Mama," on the radio, and it turned me on. And I've been hooked on music, hooked on music from that moment on. Well, all my friends thought I had one brick less than a load, 'cause I'd stop the car and I'd jump out and start dancing in the road. When I heard Jerry Lee Lewis singing, whole lot of shaking going on, and it turned me on. And I've been hooked on music from that moment on. Well, I'd steal them fancy hubcaps off them cowboys' pickup trucks, fender skirts and mud flaps, anything to make a buck. And I'd sell them right back to them out behind the rodeo, just to make a little money to take my little honey to a rock and roll show. And I hung around that skating rink where Buddy Holly played, and I could not believe one man could have such fun and still get paid. And I heard that local DJ playing, "That'll Be the Day," and it turned me on. Said it turned me on. And I've been hooked on music from that moment on. Well, I finally got some tickets to see Elvis live and hot. Well, my girlfriend almost jumped my bones going back to the parking lot. And I knew that it was not my great physique, good looks and charm that left that Texas teeny bopper's nail prints in my heart. So I bought myself a guitar and I wrote me a little song, and I changed the name to fit my latest flame, and that sucker never came out wrong. I'd sit back and sing it soft and low, watch them as it slowly turned them on. Yeah, it turned them on. And I've been hooked on music from that moment on. Yeah, hooked on music, hooked on music. I've been hooked on music from that moment on.
Okay, now this next short song that was actually Mac's last song to make it into the single digits on the charts, when this song hit number five in 1981. This one is called "You're My Bestest Friend."
Well, who wipes me off when I spill gravy on my shirt? And who knows exactly where to kiss me when I hurt? And who'd make love to me in satin sheets or in the dirt? You, babe, you're my bestest friend. Well, who takes me home when I get too drunk to dance? And who bravely puts up with my uncles and my aunts? And who discreetly whispers, "I forgot to zip my pants"? You, babe, you're my bestest friend. Well, who comes down to bail me out when I get in a jam? And helps me tell the police where I live and who I am? And who pats my back when no one else could give a damn? You, babe, you're my bestest friend. Yeah, who can be as gentle as a sparrow in my hand? Or meaner than a junkyard dog when she's fighting for her man? And who's the only one I'll ever love or understand? You, babe, you're my bestest friend. I'm talking about you, babe, you're my bestest friend.
That's one of the shorter songs I've done since I started this whole thing, I think. Of course, in the actual recording, there were all kinds of instrumentals. All right, now, to wrap up our Mac Davis collection and tonight's show, we have a couple of songs that Mac wrote that other artists had hits with. This first one was a big hit for Elvis Presley in 1969. The song was originally pitched to Sammy Davis Jr., but actually Mac Davis pitched it by playing it for him in a studio, but with other onlookers at the time, like Jesse Jackson and other members of the black activist community. Mac Davis being the only white man in the room at the time. And he wrote the song after visiting a friend of his in Chicago and feeling so depressed about the conditions in the area. The song was originally titled The Vicious Circle, but was retitled In the Ghetto.
As the snow flies on a cold and gray Chicago morning, a poor little baby child is born in the ghetto. And his mama cries, 'cause if there's one thing that she don't need, it's another little hungry mouth to feed in the ghetto. People, don't you understand? The child needs a helping hand, or he'll grow to be an angry young man someday. Take a look at you and me. Are we too blind to see? Or do we simply turn our heads and look the other way? Well, the world turns, and a hungry little boy with a runny nose plays in the street as the cold wind blows in the ghetto. And his hunger burns, so he starts to roam the streets at night, and he learns how to steal and he learns how to fight in the ghetto. Then one night in desperation, a young man breaks away. He buys a gun and he steals a car. He tries to run, but he don't get far. And his mama cries. As a crowd gathers round, an angry young man face down on the street with a gun in his hand in the ghetto. As her young man dies on a cold and gray Chicago morn, another little baby child is born in the ghetto. And his mama cries.
Okay, now for our last Mac Davis song tonight. This is a song he wrote that Bobby Goldsboro released in 1970. Bobby Goldsboro's cover of the song went to number one on the easy listening charts, number seven on the country charts, and number 11 on the pop charts. Bobby Goldsboro included the song on his album, but he didn't originally release it as a single because his record producer said, "I just don't think anyone will buy a record about a father and son." But then radio stations started playing the song like it was a single within the first couple of weeks. So they quickly produced and released a 45 single version of the song, and it continued to climb the charts thereafter. This song is called Watching Scotty Grow.
He sits with a pen and a yellow pad. What a handsome lad, that's my boy. PRLFQ spells mom and dad. Well, that ain't too bad, that's my boy. Well, you can have your TV and your nightclubs. You can have your drive-in picture shows. Stay right here with my little man dear and listen to the radio, biding my time and watching Scotty grow. Making castles out of building blocks and a cardboard box, that's my boy. Mickey Mouse says it's 13 o'clock. Well, that's quite a shock, that's my boy. In 4 short years I've grown from rags to riches. And what I did before that I don't know. So let it rain on my windowpane. I've got my own rainbow. And we're just sitting here shining, watching Scotty grow. Riding on daddy's shoulders and off to bed. Old sleepyhead, that's my boy. Gotta have a drink of water and a story read. A teddy bear named Fred, that's my boy. Well, what's that you say, mama? Come on and keep your feet warm. Save me a place, I'll be there in a minute or so. I think I'll stay right here and say a little prayer before I go. 'Cause me and God are watching Scotty grow. Yeah, me and God are watching Scotty grow.
Okay, and our gospel song for tonight, we are over. I don't know what happened. Too much talking, I think. Okay. This is the lyrics for the song were written in 1895 by Maud Battersby, the melody in 1911 by Charles Hutchinson, Gabriel, and it was first recorded in 1913 by Homer Alvin Rodehever. I could probably be pronouncing that wrong. Anyway, I learned it from 1959 Jim Reeves recording, and this is called An Evening Prayer.
If I have wounded some poor soul today, if I have caused one foot to go astray, if I have walked in my own willful way, dear Lord, forgive. If I have uttered idle words in vain, if I have turned aside from want or pain, lest I offend some other through the strain. Dear Lord, forgive. If I have been perverse or hard or cold, if I have longed for shelter in thy fold, when thou hast given me some fort to hold, dear Lord, forgive. Forgive these sins I have confessed to thee. Forgive the secret sins I do not see. Guide me, love me, and my keeper be. Dear Lord, forgive. Dear Lord, forgive.
Which, of course, takes us, as always, to our benediction for the week to send you on your way.
May the good Lord bless and keep you, whether near or far away. May you find that long-awaited golden day today. May your troubles all be small ones, and your fortune 10 times 10. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again. May you walk with sunlight shining and a bluebird in every tree. May there be a silver lining back of every cloud you see. Fill your dreams with sweet tomorrows, never mind what might have been. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again. May you walk with sunlight shining and a bluebird in every tree. May there be a silver lining back of every cloud you see. Fill your dreams with sweet tomorrows, never mind what might have been. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet again. May the good Lord bless and keep you till we meet, till we meet again.
All right. Well, thank you all for tuning in. Next week, we will start Marty Robbins. And Mighty Robbins has a lot of hits. I only have a few in my collection, but I'm going to add several this week. So it'll for sure be a full week of Mighty Robbins. I don't know how many weeks there will be of Mighty Robbins, but for sure one, maybe two. So I'm looking forward to that. He's certainly a favorite. And we will see you next Sunday at 7 Central. Hope you all can join us. Thank you for tuning in. Have a great night and have a great and safe week. Good night, everybody.